When looking for the king of podcasts, you're at the wrong channel.
Well, excuse me!
Looking for good ideas for life? You're far from good hands.
Hey, bud, what's your problem?
If you think the listener is always right, you're far from the right place.
Out of order! Even in the future, nothing works!
Hosted by a Northeasterner by birth, but a rebel by choice.
Are you threatening me?
If you want a host that floats between love and madness,
and we know the night is always gonna be here anyway. Thinking of you's working up my appetite, looking forward to a little afternoon delight.
Then play on and listen to Crazy Train Radio.
All right, guys, listen to this blues riff and B. Watch me for the changes and try and keep up, okay?
Warning, creators of this game do understand the subject matter may be offensive to some, but they do honor the families and people that have been affected by these real life tragedies that these individuals have caused. Wanna play a game?
Oh yeah!
Lover of true crime?
Yes, yes, yes.
Well, we got an interesting game for you to check out.
Wow.
With the mashup of influences such as horror movies, collecting cards, and RPGs.
What?
Led to giving birth to an incredible creation of this game, Killers the Card Game.
You are all my children now.
This game is a collectible trading card game featuring some of the most infamous killers with tidbits of trivia on the back of each card to help you learn some insight to each criminal.
Who the hell are you?
Let's not forget, during the game, cops will be chasing you and these criminals.
I'm a cop, you idiot!
However, check out their website listed through all social media today, which can be found under Killers the Card Game.
Am I on the internet?
I want to play a game.
Hey folks, it's your least favorite host in the podcast world, Croc Jonathan Steele. Boy, do we have a good one for you today.
Hey guys, I'm Courtney Lynn.
And I'm Quinn, and you are listening to Crazy Train Radio.
They say these are the best days. We don't know it till they're gone.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, you heard this duo before recently, and this duo's voices and also their lyrics have this duo's voices and lyrics have a certain layer and weave in and out with each other. So easy that most would think that they've been singing together forever. And I'm not talking Randy Travis forever and ever, amen. But this dynamic duo, Courtney Lynn and Quinn, are back because they got their new release track, which is very catchy, Whiskey Remembers. And I might have a small snippet of whiskey in my hand as they saw me pour it. But ladies, welcome. How are we doing?
We're doing good. Not as good as you with your whiskey shot, though.
I know. I'm kind of jealous, honestly. We just got shot glasses made for this single release that say Whiskey Remembers on them. So I was kind of like, dang, we should have, you know,
should have
partaken.
Yeah.
No, well, it's funny. Mine, my glass has my favorite brand name in it. And, you know, it's funny. When I talked to them, they sent me a six of these and whatnot. They sent a little care package, hat, all that fun stuff. You would think they'd just send me a bottle as much as I talk about it, you know, but.
They don't want to give the whiskey away for free, just the merchandise.
Yeah, just the gimmicks.
Yeah.
So, all kidding aside, and I can't blame them, business is business, but whiskey remembers. So, What can you tell me about this? What's the response been from people who've heard it? Give me the lowdown on this new ditty.
This was kind of a fun, different songwriting perspective. We were introduced to this fella, Kim Thomas, who lives in Wilmington as well. And he came and saw us at an open mic night here in Wilmington and reached out to us after the fact and said, "Hey, I have a bunch of songs, not really songs, but words that I would like to turn into a song. And I really love how y'all sound together. Would you guys be interested in taking one of my, you know, lyrics and making it a song?" And we said, "Yeah, let's try it. We've never done that before." And so we got the lyrics. He gave us about, I don't know, 10 or 12, mm-hmm. right? 10 or 12 different sheets of words. And this one just stood out to us. We really thought it had a really cool story.
I just felt like this is a good classic country song. Yeah. It's got all the hallmarks of a traditional country song,
but not in like a cheesy way. Like the words are different than what, you know what I mean?
Yeah, there's a good storyline in there too. And you know, Quinn and I are huge country music fans. That's one of the first things that we bonded over is our love for Garth Brooks and 90s country music. And so this just felt like a something we had to do.
Yeah.
And it's funny, you make up a good point there, Court. But no, you make a good point as far as their lyrics and storytelling and stuff. And I don't care what genre you're in, but I notice it, especially with country, and the better songs or the ones that really stand out have that good storytelling aspect to things.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, definitely.
So why don't I go ahead and insert Whiskey Remembers right here.
Thoughts, no plans, I'm putting you there. Finally in a good mood, meeting my friends like I just don't care. Did the mad thing, did the sad thing, now I'm seeing clear. Another round over here. Bartender, pour me the memories. Jim Jack and all my senses, please. Shaking my head, shaking you off. Not enough, one too many. Better hit me again. Bartender, pour me the memories. Jim Jack and all my senses, please. You may not want them, but you got them. Cause the whiskey, baby, always remembers. Set the date in September. Better make it a double. Bartender, pour me the memories. December. Set the date in September. Pick the beach in October. Ring shopping in November. Hear with Jim and Jack in December.
Coming out of Whiskey Remembers, and obviously we will have links to everything, to social media where you can get Whiskey Remembers and other things from Spotify and all the usual suspects where people get their music nowadays. But we are talking here on November 1st, right after Halloween, literally. So how did you guys spend your Halloween? But to also tie in with Whiskey Remembers, I should probably ask this here. What would be your drink of choice if we're actually having some downtime, whether we're listening to music or watching a movie or we're out with friends to dinner? And I know there are different situations and such, but what is your usual drink of choice if we decide to have a cocktail?
It's so funny that you asked that, because I think I connected with this song on a very generic level to a certain degree, because I just love whiskey. I love bourbon and I love whiskey. So in the summertime, I usually do like bourbon or whiskey with club soda and a lime. And right now, currently during the fall season, I really love a good hot toddy.
Mm-hmm. So. Yeah, I'm a whiskey or a wine girl.
Mm-hmm.
For Halloween though, we actually dressed up as for any of you who have seen the Barbie movie, I dressed up as the weird Barbie and Quinn dressed up as Alan.
Yeah, and the rejects in the movie.
And we actually played a show dressed like that, and some of our fans came up afterwards. They're like, you know, I love the costumes, but I have to be honest, it was really weird seeing you guys sing love songs to each other dressed like that. Like, yeah, I bet it was.
Yeah.
To alcohol, the cause of and solution to all of life's problems.
Oh, so you know, it's funny. I didn't see the movie. And thank you, Warner Brothers, by the way. I'll say this. They did send me the 4K Blu-ray DVD set for Barbie. Not up my alley. It's the first time I ever... Well, I shouldn't say it's the first time I ever did this. But I ended up giving it to... Because I was just in your neck of the woods, probably about 4 hours away. And I spent some time with another independent musician. She was a big savior and stuff, and don't want to drop names because that's not what she did, what she did is about. But knowing she has a little one herself, about 5-6 years old, I said, hey, I got you a present for the midget. And I said that midgets don't go email me. I'm talking child, not actual midgets.
Yeah. We represent the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, and in the name of the Lollipop Guild.
I don't need Peter Dinklage coming after me. Like, that. Never mind, we won't go down that road. But I said, hey, here you go. I figured you'd like this for you and a kiddo to watch. And she... It was funny. It started a whole different conversation. She's like, I saw the movie. She hasn't yet. So this will be great to have at home and whatever. So,
yeah. But surprisingly, though, I thought it was so much more of an adult movie than a kid's movie. Like, mm-hmm. when we saw it, I was like, not knowing what to expect. And then I saw it and I was like, oh my God, this movie's hilarious. And I think a lot of the content potentially would go over kids' heads, really.
Yeah. I mean, it's really just a satire.
Yeah, it's a satire for sure.
Yeah, that's what I've heard from everybody I talked to who's seen the movie. And that's what my friend said. She goes, you know, I loved it. A lot of adult humor. But yeah. I think my kid will still be able to enjoy it. You know, so
oh, for sure.
It was both best of both, you know, so.
Yeah. Yeah. It's really funny. I thought they did a great job for sure.
So I might have to change my opinion and maybe at least watch when it comes on the man and stuff.
There you go. Yeah.
You know, everybody said the same thing. So,
yeah.
Obviously, last time we chatted, you guys were coming home and on the road and just bouncing all over the place doing what you do. So, what is next for the remainder of the year? Do you have shows booked? Or are we going to kind of start laying low until 2024? What are we thinking?
Yeah, we're taking a little bit of a pause. And you know, we've been going at music so hard for so long, and we kind of just had like a natural lull in the schedule, and we decided to take advantage of that and let ourselves rejuvenate, recoup, maybe write some more music,
some more writing, maybe do some more recording. Along the way, we'll obviously continue to update people on socials and things like that, and also we're releasing 2 more songs. So we'll be continuing that part of stuff. But for as far as live shows, we're taking a little bit of a pause just to give ourselves some more time for creativity, some more time for rejuvenation and, you know, rebuild.
all that fun stuff, you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You got to have the work-life balance.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I know we joked about this the last time about, you know, especially when we're talking with you two in particular, being a married couple and all that fun stuff, but also work together. So mm-hmm. It's like there's that, and I'm not saying it's a bad thing. There's that 24/7 you're around each other. And we were joking about the nuances. Damn it. You left your towel on the floor. Damn, you know what I mean? Just the nitpicking of it, you know, between the two, you know, any couple and everything, you know, we were laughing and joking about that kind of thing.
Yeah, totally.
But how is that though? And all, I know we joked about it and I just tongue in cheek there, but how is that you're around each other? Yeah. You know, like there's not that separate. Well, I hope you guys are able to separate work and personal, but what is that like being around not only your partner, but you know, your coworker 24/7?
I think the hardest part of it, honestly, is just knowing when to like, having, because you get so into like a pattern. The hardest part isn't spending that much time together, it's more like
separating
the time, like making sure that we actually have good personal, you know, relationship time together, like date nights and like fun together. Because what seemingly happens sometimes is we'll intend for that to be the case, but then
we end up sitting there talking about like music marketing for 2 hours and we're like, okay.
Yeah. It's hard to turn off work brain sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
where it's like, can we have dinner and this glass of wine or shot of whiskey? And can we just, you know what I mean? Can we have this, you know, like,
and not talk about it at all.
Yeah. Can we have this half hour that we're not talking work, you know, like,
yeah. Yeah. That's the hardest part.
Oh boy. So obviously, and I'm having a brain fart, I'm sorry, and it wasn't the whiskey. Whose family's house did we say we're at now?
Oh, my Quinn. We're at my parents' home right now in Wilmington.
So that's quite interesting, because obviously no matter the relationship, and I always like to ask this, what does Quinn's parents think of Courtney here? But what's Courtney's family think of Quinn? Does everybody approve? Because you know how families are. They always, like, I want the best for my child and all that stuff. Does the families approve of you guys? It's ours. Oh, we love Courtney. You know,
I decided from the beginning.
Yeah. Right.
I decided from the beginning that I'm just going to be impossible not to like.
That's right.
So I just put my best game face on every day. And I'm always asking, like, can I help clean up the dishes? Can I help you guys with anything? Oh, you guys look so great today. I'm just going to be like painfully nice all the time. No. And I think it's worked. I think it's really worked.
Yeah, it's worked. Definitely.
And my family just adores Quinn. I mean, they, I swear, like most of the time I talk to people in my family, they're like, well, where's Quinn? Tell Quinn we said hi. Tell Quinn we love her.
They like me more than her.
Yeah. She's more fun than me, objectively.
That's not true.
Yeah. Cause it's always, you know, it's funny that families tend to like our partners better than us. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's like, she won't hear this, so I can tell the story that when my sister came to a family function and her husband was coming late because he plays music from time to time.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And yeah, you know, it's like, it's not a career for him, but they have fun with it. They're a pretty good, interesting band. So anyway, my sister shows up at this Halloween party of all things. You know, yeah, she got there first and she's like, that's it. I'm breaking up with my hubby. It's like, why? Everybody, yeah, my dad's standing there. We're all standing around. Why? Why are you breaking up with the hubby? God, he's having lunch at a brewery, damn it. And I should have been there having food and drinks with him. So my father sitting there just spent maybe 6 months prior. You know how it goes, $20,000 for a wedding and all that shit.
Oh, yeah.
Drinking his beer, he goes, well, you get divorced, we're keeping him. we're keeping him.
Yeah.
Dad, but I'm your daughter, right? Like, why aren't you keeping me? You love me, right? He's like, yeah, I love you. But pointed out to the family, because my uncle had like 7 acres and a bunch of people and driving tractors for the, you know, kids and all. He goes, look at this bunch out here. My brother-in-law is a doctor. He goes, look at this bunch here. We don't have any smart people and doctors in the family. We're keeping him. You know what I mean?
That's hilarious.
See, that's why, honey, you got to win over the in-laws.
Yeah.
He's like, honey, we love you, but he's sticking around. We got to keep the smart ones in the family.
Right. Got to keep the gene pool smarter.
Yeah, exactly. The kids have turned out okay, obviously. Got some brains to them. Mom and dad are smart, but I tease. But musically, you said you got a couple more songs coming out and you're going to keep the creativity going. So do we have a certain theme with these songs, or can we do a little tease here?
Actually, we don't have much of a theme. That's kind of why we did them all as singles, because they all sort of have their own personality, you know, and they're all very different and unique. Like Found My Love, the one we did on the show last time, is, you know, very jazzy, soulful kind of groove going on.
It's a groove.
Yeah, it's a groove. It's like more of a funky type thing than we normally do. And then Whiskey Remembers is like this straight up country song. I mean, it's very country, which we are so excited about and love. But again, they all have their personalities. And
yeah, then the next songs we have coming out, one is like a singer songwriter like kind of coffee song. House love song, and then one is like a folk, you know, like driving train deep folk song.
Yeah, so they just are all very unique and all in their own ways. And I think we decided, we really love all of them. We have like a special connection with all of them, and we wanted to put time into all of them, but we wanted to give them their own moment because of that. So that's why they're coming out as singles.
No, that works. And that's the process that's been going on the past several years between streaming and new CDs. Not that there's not physical media, but that's just the direction things have gone.
Yeah, definitely.
But last question, and make sure you check out the new single here that we obviously played and all that stuff, and go ahead, please purchase it, support these artists, because that's how we do things around here.
Yeah.
But what is the process for you guys when putting together music? Because I know I can't remember, I'm sorry, I'm in a brain fog. I know you guys were saying the last time about driving yourself nuts in terms of when you're working on things and trying to make things as best as possible. But how do you know when it's time to release the bird into the world, if that makes sense?
Never. I mean, you never know. I think the answer is always never.
I think there's always, if, at least for me, there's always like, oh, I feel like we could, you know, we could, I could do better vocals. I could come up with some more powerful moments or runs in here. And then musically, better we're like, dynamics. How do we create better dynamics or more intricate parts? And who should we have play on this? I mean, you'll drive yourself mad doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And so at some point, you just have to say, like, you just have to take a deep breath and
let go.
And let go.
Yeah. Well, and the cool thing about this song too, though, the song Whiskey Remembers, is we really appreciated the co-working with the lyricist that we worked with, Kim Thomas from Wilmington. And I thought that the song had some very powerful words, and we've gotten some feedback on that. Like, we entered it into a couple of contests. It's like a finalist in a contest right now in the UK. And also we got some feedback from like Song Door, which is like a place where you can get it reviewed. And they basically said, like, this is a very strong song. Like, the dynamics are great. The words are great. So this was just a really cool experience and a very different, different songwriting process than we've normally taken. So yeah.
I don't know. First song we've ever released that we haven't personally written the words to.
Yeah.
Interesting. And, you know, Quinn, you just mentioned about going overseas or having stuff heard overseas and stuff. Have you guys had an opportunity to go overseas to perform yet, or?
Not yet, but
no, but our, you know, goal. Our analytics are interesting these days. Like, mm-hmm. we're getting a lot of feedback from like Australia.
Mm-hmm.
And like some
places,
you know,
in Europe.
Yeah, like, yeah, some European countries. So, you know, hey,
you never know. We did have
that'd be a dream.
A person who currently resides in Mexico, who's also a musician, who sets up this music festival every year for himself and like other artists that he appreciates. And he basically invited us to do that. So who knows? Maybe we'll play in Mexico. You never know.
Hey, and have yourself a Mai Tai and whatnot. But, hey, you know, because the reason I ask, because as you said that about the international flavor, you notice with your analytics and people listening and such. I find it interesting because I was recently talking to a solo artist, and she's played a lot in like Europe and Ireland and different things. It has the same thing with the analytics. And the thing that she told me about those audiences is, she obviously made the effort to go over there, which it's not like jumping in a car and going to Indiana or going to here, what we do here in the States. But so she had fans coming from 4 or 5, 6 hours away from where the shows were to come see. Because that fan base appreciates, if you're making the effort to come overseas, they were going to make the effort to come see you.
Wow, that's cool. That's awesome.
Yeah.
And I know in my analytics and stuff, there's a lot of overseas listenership and stuff. So if you have interest in hearing or seeing Courtney and Quinn and can help legitimately want to book them for shows, I'm not saying I'm an agent or anything like that, but I can definitely put you guys in the right touch to have these girls come over and start those discussions, because obviously they're worth seeing if we can get them some shows. And I don't mind if people, I'm putting the karma out in the world, if
there people, you go
you know, if people want to see them, if I can be of assistance in any way to help bring them to a new audience, either in person or to purchase the music and such, I'm all for it. So,
well, thank you for that.
Yeah, thank you so much.
I want to put the good juju or whatever out there.
That's right.
That's right. You have to, right? That's the only way.
Exactly. If I'm one of those, you put it out there, that's when things happen. So,
exactly.
But where is the best spot, social media wise, to check you guys out?
You know, we've made this really easy. If you search Courtney Lynn and Quinn, I mean, you'll find everywhere we are. So we're on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook.
We have our own website.
We have a website. Yeah. So, I mean, if you just type in Courtney Lynn and Quinn,
you'll find us.
And I didn't tell you the last time, but I just love how that flows, you know, together. Courtney Lynn and Quinn.
Yeah. Right.
Well,
it's great. It's just our names, but it worked out.
Yeah. it just something about how it flows, you know, it works. And not only will they do music for you, but they also do magic tricks. Yeah.
Oh, really? Oh, that's
I don't know. What the hell?
I might have to call my old boss to get some tricks up my sleeve.
Oh, yeah. Quinn used to work for a magician.
Yeah.
We could have a whole podcast just on the weird jobs we've had.
That is very true.
Oh, God. That could be part three.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Boy. But ladies, thank you so much for the time.
Oh, thank you. So we really appreciate being on the show again. Thanks for having us on the crazy train. Woo, woo. You know. Yep.
I know I'll be talking to you guys again soon. So, but if I don't, beforehand, have a good holiday season and best of luck with the new song.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having us on again, and you have a happy holiday season as well.
Hey there, Friday fans. We know how much you enjoy the movies. Enjoy grabbing your Friday merchandise and interacting with the Friday family, whether it be at conventions or during our particular watch-alongs. Well, when you're looking to get yourself masks, why not check out our friends over at Camp Blood Customs out of New York State and order your specific custom mask from any of the films. All orders are made specifically. Your needs and wants are. Make sure you find Camp Blood Customs on Facebook, Instagram, and all over social media and order yours today.
Hi everyone, this is David Sanchez. You're listening to Crazy Train Radio.